¿Estos qué son, mis quejotes?
Sí.
At a food donation stall outside a Sherman Heights home, an elderly man sifts through bags of dried black beans, rice, and onions.
Ay, no. Nomás la agarra y le echa limoncito. La pela y le echa limoncito.
Since the pandemic started, many like this man have relied on these food stalls that have expanded across the South Bay region, says volunteer Araceli Mauricio.
Toda la gente que ha venido aquí dice, oh, dice que es una buena ayuda, porque mucha gente ya perdió su trabajo.
In fact, unemployment rates in places like National City are nearly double that of Del Mar and Poway. But it's not just unemployment that's surging. Compared to these northern suburbs, Imperial Beach and Chula Vista have on average 3 times the coronavirus case rate. Mauricio says there's a lot of reasons the spread could be high. People don't like wearing masks, but still like having gatherings, and there's more.
Sí, lo que pasa es que la gente pues está preocupada en la renta, en la comida, en lo demás, pues, y es mucha gente hasta tienen miedo a salir a la clínica.
Mauricio says while people are concerned about their health, they're scared going to the clinic could lead to missing a paycheck to pay for rent or food.
No, hombre, vea qué buena está, no, hombre.
Christian Ramirez is standing at the top of Grant Hill in Sherman Heights. He's the policy director of the labor union SEIU, United Service Workers West.
Behind me are the hardest hit zip codes of COVID-19 positive cases in the entire county, Chula Vista, National City.
Ramirez says the community does have a lot of essential workers and businesses like grocery stores. Those stores keep the economy running, but workers are at high risk for contracting coronavirus. But he says those issues are part of a larger problem contributing to COVID cases here. And that's a historical lack of healthcare resources in low-income Latino communities.
These are working class communities, but these are also communities that historically have been neglected. You know, not far from here is an abandoned hospital, for instance, that used to serve this community 20, 30 years ago and now has been abandoned.
That's where San Diego General Hospital shut down in 1991.
And when you have a population of folks who have been left to fend for themselves for a long time without adequate services, without adequate information that is culturally relevant, that is accessible in multiple languages, then this happens. The pandemic just grabs hold of these socioeconomic factors and spreads.
KPBS has reported that 87% of the region's 7,000 hospital beds are in the city of San Diego and cities north of San Diego, leaving fewer than 900 total beds in South Bay cities.
We're telling communities, get out there and work, provide for us, but if you get sick, well, good luck to you.
Greg Cox is the outgoing supervisor for District 1, which covers South Bay.
I think I've worked very closely with the South County elected officials, the mayors of Chula Vista, National City, and Imperial Beach.
County officials say spread is high in this region because of the concentration of essential workers. They also say cross-border traffic may contribute to higher rates. Cox says officials have reached out in Spanish and increased access to testing.
We've got over 50 testing sites. On some days, we've had as many as 63 different testing sites.
Cox says the county has tried to offer assistance for rent and food.
And can we do more? Yeah, we can.
Incoming County Supervisor Nora Vargas agrees. Vargas is from the district and will be the first Latina woman to hold that seat. She says support must include practical solutions like financial assistance.
It means people have better opportunities to access, for instance, CalFresh, you know, being able to advocate so that the government can continue to provide the EBT emergency card so that people can have that access to that food right now.
Vargas was an executive with Planned Parenthood for 20 years. She says it's important for county leaders to build trust so people go to a community health center or get a COVID test.
It's not just an email and a text, right? It's actually getting out there in the community and having conversations.
Vargas says people in the South Bay who are worried about feeding their families won't be able to focus on their health care, especially if those health care resources are scarce. Shalina Chotlani, KPBS News.